What you are about to see is the very apex of pugilistic fortitude. The challenger from Cincinnati, Ohio, Bert the Butcher Groom! And the defending champion, the iron-fisted pugilist, Hard-Nosed Henry Fox! Gentlemen, gentlemen, you understand the rules. That being that there are no rules. Then I say, let the best man win!
Come on, quit dancing! What are you doing here? This isn't exactly your kind of crowd.
Well, let's just say I have a personal interest.
Yeah, that's them, all right. Isn't this great?
Barbaric.
Oh, I love it.
Looking at me like that?
I'm sorry. I'm surprised is all. I didn't know you associated with pugilists.
I don't. I find the sport repulsive. It's barbaric. It appeals to our baser instincts. But when I saw Henry's name on the poster, I just had to come and see if it was really him.
And who is he?
He's an old childhood friend of mine. He used to live down the road from me.
I must have walked down that road a million times. Maybe two. Henry Fox.
Will, it's a pleasure. Kate was just telling me about your shared childhood.
Kate, is it? Oh, you'll always be Katie to me. We were two peas in a pod back then, weren't we?
Indeed, we were.
Henry, I'm a boxing fan, but I gotta admit, I wouldn't peg a friend of Kate's to be a boxer.
You and me both. But you do what you gotta do.
Henry Fox?
That's right.
Miss Fox, I'm bringing you in for the murder of Bert Grove.
Bert? What are you talking about? You got it wrong. Bert's the one knocked me out.
What's the meaning of this, Logan?
Bert Grove was found lying in a snowbank out past Shantytown, dead. No knife wound, no bullet wound. It is my professional opinion that the man died as a result of the fight.
You have no grounds to arrest this man. Even if the deceased perished as a result of the boxing match, he entered into it voluntarily.
Kansas City Municipal Ordinance Number 43A, the death of any person involved in an unsanctioned pugilistic event shall be deemed murder.
Katie! Beginning to think I didn't have a single friend left.
You'll always have a friend in me, Henry. You know that.
I appreciate that, Katie. I really do. It's been a tough few years.
Perhaps it would have been easier had you not spent it breaking noses.
Yeah. Well, what can I say? I'm flat broke.
How? What about the farm?
When times got tough during the war, Father took out a mortgage on it. He died a few years later, and
Mama couldn't keep up with the payments.
I'm so sorry.
Damn bank took the farm. Won't give it back unless we can afford it.
Surely there are better ways of making money than pugilism.
I was always good at fighting. You know that. I didn't kill Burke Grove. You gotta believe me.
I do believe you, Henry. And I'm going to help clear your name.
Afraid I'm not following.
I do this for a living, Henry. I'm a Pinkerton agent.
Well, I'll be damned. You always were a spirited one, Katie.
Free until your trial, Miss Fox. Bond's been paid.
By who?
By me.
Thank you.
Let's go.
What's he doing here?
I told him he could stay here until we clear his name.
Until we clear his name?
This is obviously a miscarriage of justice that needs to be remedied. I've offered Henry our services.
Can I speak to you for a minute?
Henry, why don't you go put your things in the tack room? It's okay. Are you all right?
No, I'm not all right. You offer our services to a suspected murderer without even consulting me?
I don't remember Alan saying anything about me needing to consult you.
The point is, how do you know we can trust him?
I've known him since I was a child. I know the type of man he is.
Well, is he the type of man who has the money to pay us?
He's a dear friend of mine who needs my help. I've never asked a favor of you before this. Please, help me.
Okay, fine. But on one condition.
Name it.
I'm leading the investigation.
No.
Yes.
No,
yes.
This is my case.
Oh, really? And what would my father say about your emotional connection to the client?
Alan would say my emotional connection to the client has the potential to cloud my unbiased judgment.
Poor Grovesy. There's no way I killed him.
Why not?
I got a strong technique, but there's no way I could have hit him hard enough to kill him. Grovesy was made of iron.
What was he like?
Tough. Quiet. And drank like a fish. I know that. He never cared to make many friends.
And what about enemies?
Just about anyone he ever knocked out. Guy had a hell of a punch.
It's like you got one yourself.
Comes with a job, I guess.
Well, I believe our first order of business is to examine the body and...
Excuse me, I'm the one calling the shots on this one, remember?
Yes. Of course. Where to first?
Mabel, honey, come here. These folks need to have a word with you.
Okay, but no discounts.
We don't need that kind of service. This is about your client, Burt Grove. Boxer who died last night?
Sure, I remember him.
What can you tell us about him?
We didn't do much talking, but he paid me. Paid me well, in fact, what with all that money exchanging hands.
What do you mean?
He had people coming and going from his room all hours, mostly paying him money, though sometimes he gave them some.
Thanks for your time. What do you make of that? Your friend Henry says that Bert didn't make any friends. Here, Mabel's telling us that he was quite popular.
More importantly, money was exchanged. The deceased was a gambler.
Or a loan speculator.
Indeed. What's our next step?
I want you to talk to that boxing promoter, see if he knows anything about a gambling ring, and see what I can learn from the other boxers.
Perhaps we should examine the body now, determine a cause of...
Excuse me?
Very well.
Well, I'm very pleased that someone is investigating Grove's death. Not only is Henry one of my closest friends, he's also my number one moneymaker. I don't think my business will survive if he's hanged.
Well, I believe with your help, we have a strong chance of clearing his name.
Good. Because Henry Fox is no murderer. I don't care what that podunk sheriff says. To rest assured, you'll have my full cooperation.
What can you tell me about Burt Grove?
I picked him up in Virginia City a few years back. Punching him was like punching a brick wall.
Was he a gambling man?
Gambling? No chance. My fighters aren't allowed to gamble. It leads to corruption of the sport. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a telegram to send to Bert's family.
Of course. You won't mind if I return with a few more questions?
Well, in fact, I welcome it. Anything to help clear Henry's name. If a fighter's a moneymaker, I'll do anything to protect them.
Oh. Thank you.
Well, I'll be. Ain't y'all the pugilist from the Wild last night?
On your way, Tony. We's busy.
I'm sorry for disturbing y'all. I'm very enthusiastic about the pugilistic arts. Well, that was some fight last night, huh? It's a shame about the fellow who died, though.
You'll find no tears here. Grovesy had it coming.
What do you mean?
Burt Grove was a liar. And a welch.
You're just saying that because he owed you $50.
Maybe I ought to take it out of your skull.
I'm just saying. It ain't right to talk ill of the dead.
As for you, Tony, you can get the hell out of here.
Well, I meant no offense, sir. I'll be on my way. Best of luck tonight, y'all.
It wasn't what he said, but how he said it. I mean, if a man is a moneymaker, I'll do anything to protect him.
Huh. So you think that Zeke killed Bert because Bert knocked out Henry?
I admit it's weak, but we can't rule out Zeke as a suspect.
There's also the big Irish guy, O'Brien. Bert owed him $50, and that's a motive if I've ever heard one.
Okay, so we have two prime suspects.
Three. I haven't crossed Henry off of my list.
Fine. We have three prime suspects. What's our next step?
Yes, next step.
It might be good to determine a cause of death. Perhaps we examine the body now.
That's a great idea. Why didn't you mention that sooner?
None of the usual pupil blackening or bruising associated with a blow to the head. No wounds of any kind.
What's this on his face? Looks kind of like mud.
It is the caking you'd expect of mud that's dried, but the particles are too small. Some kind of herb. Hot like chili powder, but bitter like milkweed.
Yeah, not the kind of thing you expect to find on a dead guy's face. What do you make of it?
Well, in the absence of certainty, the hypothesis with the least assumptions is usually the correct one. This man didn't die in a boxing match. I believe he was poisoned. We've completed a thorough examination of the body, and based on evidence, I'd say that Grove was murdered after the fight, not killed during it.
That don't mean Fox is innocent.
No, but we still have two prime suspects with very clear motives. Zeke Slayton, the boxing promoter, he could have done it to protect his best fighter.
And Kerry O'Brien, the Irish boxer. He had an axe to grind over money that Grove owed him. But in either case, it's more than enough evidence to release the bond on Fox.
Is that so? Well, according to the boxers that I interviewed, Henry Fox is a cheat. He covers his hands in chili powder before each fight to interfere with his opponent's eyesight. The way I see it, Fox was upset that Grove beat him, so he decided to knock down his competition once and for all. I guess you two ain't the only people in Kansas City that can solve a puzzle.
Look, I don't care how amazing that contraption is. It isn't gonna tell us the killer's name.
It's a microscope. Like a magnifying glass, only it's used to examine extremely small objects, like the residue on Grove's face.
Well, you be sure to let me know if any of them have a name tag that reads Zeke Slayton, Kerry O'Brien, or Henry Fox.
I still don't think Henry is the killer.
Well, in the absence of clarity, I believe the solution is, you know it. But anyway, the point is, after what Logan said, I gotta admit, your old pal's looking mighty suspicious.
Will, I know the man. I know his history. He's not a murderer. Besides, what would you have me do? Go up and ask him if he sticks his hand in poison before the fight?
Yeah, that'd be a great start.
How would he prevent the poison from affecting him?
Who's to say it hasn't affected him? When's the last time you looked at Henry's hands? Look, one of us needs to ask him about it.
I suppose that will be you?
Actually, no. I think your connection with him will give you a much better chance of learning the truth.
Thank you, Will. It's nice to see you using your brain for once.
Don't make me change my mind.
So, how'd it go with the sheriff?
Not well. He says that you're a liar and a cheat who killed Burt Grove because you're upset he beat you.
What do you think?
I think there are plenty of motives to go around.
Oh. Come on. Now, Katie.
I found residue on Bert's face. Do you know anything about that?
Chili powder.
Henry.
Before you go raising holy hell, you gotta understand. Everyone cheats somehow. Low blows, hands dipped in chili powder, or worse.
Why?
Everyone wants to win. Zeke only pays us when we win.
It's terrible.
Now, I made a lot of bad decisions in my life, Katie. The worst of them was letting you leave New York.
You couldn't have stopped me.
But I sure wish I'd tried.
I know what you're doing with Kate.
Pardon me?
Leaning on her emotions? If you're pulling the wool over us, so help me, they're gonna have to wheel you out of Kansas City. Understand?
I understand completely. Just something about Katie brings out the fire in men who have feelings for her. Isn't there?
Everything okay?
What? Yeah. Just keep looking into the poison.
I'll see what I can find in Burke Grove's room.
All right, you weasel. Where's me cut?
You're looking at the last of it. I don't got a dime to spare.
I'm guessing you don't value your life much, Teller.
Over there, big fella. Miss Annalee enforces a strict no-fighting policy.
This don't concern you, Tony.
It does now. No matter how big you are, two against one ain't gonna work out so well.
Next time, you give me my cut first. I'd hate to see you end up like old Grovesy.
Thanks, partner. Name's Simon. Simon Teller.
Will, pleasure to meet you.
Yeah.
You're one of them pugilists, ain't you?
That's right.
Well, hope I didn't interrupt anything between you and the big Irish fella.
Nothing. I don't appreciate being interrupted.
What happened? Your shoe's dog or something?
No. Just a little forgetful when it comes to paying him his weekly cut of my winnings.
You let him do that?
Sure. We all do. The guy punches like he's got lead hands. I don't want to end up like Grovesy.
What the hell are you doing in here?
Nothing that concerns you.
Give it to me, or I'll shoot.
Pretty hard to shoot someone without a gun. That's a bookmaking journal, isn't it? Burke Grove was taking bets on the fights.
You're smart, for a woman. Now, why don't you use that brain of yours and give me the book?
I think you're forgetting I'm the one with the gun.
I can't believe the nerve of that guy, hitting a woman?
O'Brien's no gentleman. We're lucky that's all he did.
Thank you for your concern, Henry, but I'm quite fine. Where are you going?
Oi, I thought I told you to leave us alone.
That's for hitting a woman. Pardon the interruption. I'll be on my way.
No, wait just a minute, my boy. A word, if you please.
This was between him and me.
Oh, forget about that.
You ever considered becoming a pugilist?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I thought about it, but you really think I'd be good at it?
With a punch like that? I think you'd be great. What do you say?
So, what's the story with your friend Will Pinkerton?
Well, he's hardly my friend. He's my partner, to be precise.
What I'm asking is, if you two get along all right.
Sure, we get along fine. Yes, he can be irresponsible and stubborn and impulsive, but he means well.
Sounds like a boy to me. What you need is a man.
Henry, I have to be honest. It's quite obvious that you still have feelings for me.
Feelings? It's too weak a word.
Yes, well, the fact is that I still feel the same way as I did that day I left New York. I care about you deeply, Henry, as a friend.
You're gonna sit there and tell me that you don't feel the same fire that I do?
Retrieved it.
Yeah, in a manner of speaking. It's a bookmaking journal, all right. Grove was taking bets on all the boxers, including you, Henry.
Is that true?
Now, wait, Katie. We all bet on the fights. Between O'Brien taking his cut and Zeke taking his, we hardly make enough to buy a decent meal. Go ahead, take a look. See if I ever bet on my own fights. I may be a gambler, but I ain't crooked.
He's right. None of Henry's bets are on his own fights.
I didn't kill Burt Grove. I swear on my father's grave. If you'll excuse me, I have to get loose for tonight's fight.
I can't believe you.
Pardon me?
The killer is sitting at your table, and all you can do is enjoy a meal with him.
What makes you so sure he's the killer?
I know he's mixed up in this somehow. And you'd think so, too, if he didn't have your head all in a jumble.
My head is fine. And you know, Will, you seem to be spending an inordinate amount of time analyzing my feelings.
I'm just concerned, okay?
Bitter. Foxglove, also known as digitalis, fatally poisonous to all animals, including man.
Where's that black book?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I was gonna wait till we boxed each other. But now, I think I'm just gonna kill you right here.
Save it for tonight, O'Brien. I can't stand that guy.
Makes two of us.
Listen, Will, I want to clear the bad air between us. I'm not trying to get in your way. Vis-a-vis Katie, gotta understand, we have a lot of history, her and me.
Rest assured, there's nothing to get in the way of vis-a-vis me and Kate. Except a murder investigation in which you're a prime suspect.
You don't still think I had anything to do with Grovesy's death, do you?
So you're saying I should stay on his inside?
Yeah, he goes wide, really wide.
So he wants inside.
Okay. Ready for your first fight?
Yes, sir. Feel like I could take down a bear.
Good. Unfortunately, I don't think tonight's your night.
Oh, no. I feel good.
You're not listening to me. You're gonna lose tonight. I've got a big purse riding on O'Brien. Listen, you play by the rules and I'll make sure you get a cut of the winnings. You cross me. Well, you're a smart kid.
What the hell?
All the fights are fixed, Will. That's just the way it is.
Really? How about on the night that Henry fought Bert? Is that fixed too?
Sure was. Only Bert was supposed to take the fall, not Henry. I suppose Zeke was very happy about that. Excuse me. Hey, good luck, champ.
Oh, what the heck? What happened to you?
The brown residue on Bert's face, it was dried foxglove. It's deadly, but only when ingested. There's no way residue on a boxer's fist could kill a man.
Okay, and why are you covered in dirt?
I had to exhume Bert's body.
What?
John and I, we dug him up. Will, his lungs were full of water. He wasn't poisoned. He was drowned.
Oh, my God. Look, I just found out that all the fights are fixed. Bert wasn't supposed to win the night he died.
Well, who had the most to lose if Bert disobeyed?
Next fight of the night pits our hard-swinging Irishman, Kerry O'Brien, against a tough newcomer from right here in town. Will, the Kansas City Kid.
Kansas City Kid?
It's got a nice ring to it.
Will, you don't have to do this.
Yes, I do.
Gentlemen, let the best man win!
To let me hit you eventually, or else the knockout won't look convincing.
You said I'm getting knocked out.
Obviously, you didn't do this.
You are a fool, Pinkerton, but even I know you're not dumb enough to kill someone before dozens of witnesses.
What the hell am I doing in here?
Clearly, you're being framed. Let's let the culprit believe that their plan's working for a little while.
You think Zeke's behind it?
Probably. But unless we can place him at Bert's murder scene, Logan won't arrest him.
Well, what can I say? I enjoy having your company.
I think it's time for me to pay Mr. Slayton another visit. Unless... of course, you have a better plan since you're leading the investigation.
Well, I can't rightly do that from behind bars now, can I?
To what do I owe the pleasure, Mrs. Warren?
I promised I would return with a few more questions about the investigation.
I imagined you had that just about wrapped up, seeing as how the local boy is going to hang for the murder?
Well, that's just it. The local boy killed O'Brien, but he has an alibi for the night of Groves' murder. In fact, just about everyone's whereabouts are accounted for that evening. Except for yours, Mr. Slayton.
Well, don't you worry about me, ma'am. After the fight that night, I enjoyed the company of some of Kansas City's fairest maidens.
If you really want to know who killed Burt Grove, you should talk to Henry about his gambling debts.
Gambling debts?
I'm surprised you never mentioned it, seeing as how you two are such good friends.
That man is lying through his teeth.
What do you mean?
I don't care what he says. He ain't spent a dime on any of my girls since he's been here.
Thank you.
You're not going after him alone, are you?
No. Just send a telegram.
Hey, Katie. Any luck with the sheriff? What's this?
Telegram from the Bank of Albany. It says that you, not your father, took out a mortgage on the farm. Did you mortgage the farm to repay your gambling debts?
Katie, the whole reason I became a boxer was to buy back the farm. Why would I be doing this if I was the one who mortgaged it?
Can you explain why your name is on the mortgage?
That's how Daddy had it worked out in his last will and testament.
Where were you the night Burt Grove was murdered?
If you honestly think me, Henry Fox, a guy you've known since childhood, is capable of murder, then you should go ahead and lock me up right now. I'm sorry. I didn't mean
it. No. I'm sorry, Henry. Shouldn't have doubted you. You've always been good to me.
Slight, sir. You gotta believe me, I didn't kill O'Brien.
Do me a favor and keep that between you and me, okay?
Afraid I'm not following, sir.
What if I told you I could get you out of here, free and clear of all charges?
So you got my attention.
Good. You see, blood draws sharks, and I've got a whole town willing to pay triple the entry price to see you fight Henry Fox. The champion versus the murderer.
You're saying if I fight Henry, he'll get me out of here?
I see you're following me now.
You just gonna let me walk, Sheriff?
Well, let's just say that Mr. Slayton here has uncovered some very convincing evidence that exonerates you.
It'll be a fair fight. Best man wins, you have my word.
Best man wins, huh?
That's right. So what do you say?
I think you got yourself a deal.
Slayton.
You were supposed to keep him here for protection.
Well, I thought that was part of the plan.
What plan?
Gentlemen, I'm pleased to say that the wait is finally over. And tonight, our defending champion, the iron-fisted pugilist, hard-hitting Henry Fox, will attempt to avenge the death of his friend and comrade, Cary O'Brien. May he rest in peace.
Henry! Come on!
By fighting the butcher of Kansas City, the devilish, the murderous, Will, the Kansas City Killer!
What are you doing?
What do you think I'm doing?
Will, you have to listen to me. I took a closer look at Groves' journal. Turns out that Henry was betting on his own fights. He went against himself at times.
And now, here's our champion, Henry Fox!
So Henry's the lead suspect in this investigation?
I'm not willing to rule Zeke out, but there's no doubt in my mind that Henry's involved somehow.
Sorry, Kate. I know how much he means to you.
None of that matters now.
done.
What's your plan?
I'm gonna start by knocking his teeth out.
With the blood of Cary O'Brien barely dry on his hands.
Will, please don't do this. I'm afraid they're gonna try and kill you like they did Bert.
You're afraid they'll try? Kate, I'm counting on it.
The killer comes again. And may the best.
Told us about the mortgage.
Doesn't prove anything.
By how you changed all the figures in Bert's journal.
Can't pin that on me.
You're a liar that cheats. Yeah, I think I can. Remember when I told you if you lied to Kate, they'd have to wheel you out of town?
What of it?
That's likely the foxglove.
Wait, the what?
The foxglove. Dried flowers. Henry covered his hands with them before the flight.
Isn't that some kind of poison?
Well, yeah, but only if you swallow it. Oh. Sure does a number on you if you breathe it in, though. Don't worry, it'll wear off soon. But you know what won't wear off?
What's that?
Drowning. There.
Let him go, or the next one's in your heart, Slayton. Will, are you all right? This is how you killed Grove, isn't it? Henry weakened him with the foxglove, and you took him up here to drown him.
It's a nice work of fiction, Missy.
I exhumed his body. His lungs were full of water.
You're wasting your time. I've got that sheriff in the palm of my hand. No one's gonna believe.
That's where you're wrong. I heard the whole thing, Slayton. You and your friend here are under arrest for the murders of Bert Grove and Cary O'Brien.
And the attempted murder of me.
All right, that too.
What kind of a sheriff are you, letting a woman do your work for you?
He had it coming.
So Zeke Slayton and Henry Fox fixed the boxing matches in order to make as much money as possible.
Turns out Mr. Slayton was willing to do anything to protect his profits, including murder.
And trying to frame me for it.
Well, I think that just about covers it. Let me go see if the judge is sober enough to hear a case.
Katie. Katie. I'm sorry.
As am I.
Everything I said to you about the way I feel, it's all true.
Only you were honest about the rest.
I never meant for any of this to happen. I'm not a bad person, Katie. You know the kind of man I am.
I thought I did, Henry. You're not that man anymore. Let's go, Will.
never got a chance to thank you for saving my life back then.
You never would have been in that situation if I had listened to you in the first place.
That's okay. You know, but for what it's worth, he really is a handsome fella. Did you two ever,
A lady doesn't kiss and tell.
Ah, so you kissed him.
If you'll excuse me, I have a telegram to send.
To who?
To Alan. It's a precise detailing of my failures during this case and my suggestions for an appropriate punishment.
Can I see that for a second?
What are you doing?
The only thing that you're guilty of is being human. Thankfully, God created the perfect remedy for that.
Let me guess. Whiskey?
Actually, on a day like today, I was thinking a cup of tea.
Not whiskey?
Hey, who's in charge of this investigation?
Next week on The Pinkertons.
What the hell is he doing back in Kansas City?
Kenji!
Mio, the mystical.
Revelations will be made.
Someone in this room
will be murdered this very night.
Dear God!
What's wrong with him?
She's mine by right.
You will give up your claim on this woman.